if you ever have the chance to go back in time and change history, don't worry about whatever might happen in the upcoming election. There are much bigger fish to fry. Go back 3 billion years to when the biggest mistake in evolutionary history happened. 3 billion years ago, chlorophyll, the light-absorbing molecule in plants that powered photosynthesis, popped into existence, and from there, all of our troubles stemmed. While the rate at which plants photosynthesize food and fuels from carbon dioxide and sunlight has sufficed for the last 3 billion years, within the last 100 years, we've become acutely aware that plants struggle to fuel our exponentially growing population, and chlorophyll's inability to absorb a lot of sunlight is largely to blame. At best, chlorophyll only absorbs 12% of the sun's energy, and in actuality, plants generally muster efficiencies in the range of less than 1%. Obviously, this is no longer good enough. In contrast, modern solar panels now average efficiencies in the range of 15 to 20%, although they do remain fairly expensive to produce. If you have the chance to go back in time and change history, fix chlorophyll. But barring that magical ability, you may turn to the amalgamation of chemistry and biology that is my research. Over the past few years, I developed an alternative, better version of photosynthesis called artificial photosynthesis. Rather than rely on inefficient chlorophyll to harvest sunlight, I've taught bacteria how to grow and cover their bodies with tiny semiconductor nanocrystals, which are much more efficient than chlorophyll and can be grown at a fraction of the cost of manufacturing conventional solar panels. Once covered with these essentially tiny solar panels, these bacteria are able to grow and photosynthesize food, fuels, pharmaceuticals, and plastics, all utilizing solar energy. These bacteria already outperform natural photosynthesis, and as I teach them to grow different types of solar panels, these bacteria's efficiencies are only expected to go higher. These cyborg bacteria, this combination of chemistry and biology, living and non-living, serves as the first step in a revised, alternative, and arguably better evolutionary history, one in which we are not limited by chlorophyll's inefficiencies, and one that will allow us to grow and evolve for many generations to come. With the power to wield both chemistry and biology in tandem to redress historical and evolutionary missteps, the question now becomes, what do we fix next? Thank you.